Good morning. This is Dr. Thomas Bartel, board-certified plastic surgeon specializing in body recontouring surgery. And welcome to Wisconsin's winter wonderland. It has started, folks. It may probably be a while until we see the north side of freezing temperatures again, so we'll all just have to get used to it. This morning I thought I'd spend a few minutes talking about breast lifts. Breast lifts, or mastopexy, which is the medical term for it. This is an operation that is I perform really quite frequently. It's actually become the second most frequent operation I do. A breast lift is performed for women whose breasts have started to droop or sag. Now this can happen for a number of reasons. Gravity, post-pregnancy deflation, that's very common with women who've had breastfeeding, and they always tell me that what they want is what they had before. They want it back. The baby sucked all the breasts out of them. And the third area, third reason that people have this done is post-bariatric surgery, post-massive weight loss. Breasts have been stretched out, the skin has been stretched out, so it's drooping. And since breasts are mostly fat, I mean, that's what they are. It's not sexy, but that's what they are. If you lose a lot of weight, and many women lose their weight here, and they have a very deflated look, and that needs to be addressed with some type of breast lift or mastopexy surgery. Now, a lot of women will come in and say, here's what I want, and they'll grab themselves and go like this. And sure, I'm sure they look just fine if you do that, but you can't do that in the operating room, because that would leave scars up here. And you can't have scars up here because women like to wear these low-cut V-neck outfits, and you can't have scars there. So where we put the scars are underneath, where they're not shown. So really, if you think about it, a breast lift isn't really a breast lift, it's a breast push. Everything is pushed upwards, and that leaves the scars here underneath, so you can wear those sexy necklines and no one knows I was ever there. What a breast lift really is a skin removal operation. For women who are happy with their size, they just want what they look like with a push-up bra, then we're simply doing a breast lift. A breast lift removes skin from usually the inner and outer areas of the breast, as well as a little underneath and a little above, and the rest of the skin is lifted up and the breast is tucked up and the rest of the skin comes around and holds it up like a sling. Now this, of course, will leave scars on the breast, and people need to be prepared for that. Now scars are usually around the areola, the colored area, a short one underneath, and in most cases, a short little scar that's right underneath the breast horizontally. Scars, the one around the areola gives many people the wrong impression. They think that we actually take that thing off and then sew it back on. No, that's not true. What we do is we remove the skin around the areola, but the areola and the nipple itself are left attached to the underlying breast tissue, which allows for continued sensation in that area. Now scars are inevitable. That's just the way that skin heals. It's not my rule, that's her rule. But scars go through a very predictable sequence of events as they mature. A scar will start to get red and hard for several weeks after surgery, but then after a while it starts to fade and soften. So although a scar is permanent, scars never disappear, they will fade for up to 2 years. So when you come to my office and you're looking in my books, I always show before and afters. The afters I show are scars that are about 3 months post-op, and they're still very noticeable. I do that on purpose. I want you to see that scar, because it does no one any good if I just show my 5-year post-ops when you can hardly see the scar. I want you to see it. I think that's the only fair way to do it, because you're going to be living with that scar for a while. So you have to be prepared for that scar. That's just the way that wounds heal. Many patients will come to me and they'll say, yeah, I want it lifted, but you know, I'd love to be a little bit bigger. There are a lot of plastic surgeons who will not put an implant in at the same time as a breast lift. And I can understand that. A breast implant is pushing against your scars, and that tends to spread the scar apart and give you bad scars. If you're careful with how big an implant you put in, though, that shouldn't be a problem. And I always will tell patients, I'm happy to add a little volume with an implant behind my breast lifts, but you have to be a little circumspect about what size you go to. What we're doing is we're lifting everything up, and then I'm adding a little volume up here. If you want to be significantly larger, then we stage the operations. We do the breast lift, let the scars heal, mature, fade, and then I put an implant in. If I do it at the same time, we get bad scars. And scarring is really the only downside of a breast lift. You know, the shape of the breast is great, everything's up, but you do have those scars. So as long as you don't want to be too large, just add a little bit more volume, get back what you used to have, I'm happy to put an implant in at the same time. Now, recovery from breast lifts are pretty easy. If it's just the lift itself, there are really not a lot of downtime here, not a lot of post-op limitations. If I put an implant in, then the limitations are due to the breast implant, not the lift itself. So those are the ones I have patients with their arms down for a couple of weeks. So you're down here, you can't be doing anything up here. But with just a lift alone, most folks who are at desk jobs are back to work in 5 to 7 days. It's not a big deal. Not a lot of pain involved. It's really a fairly easy procedure to recover from. Who comes in to see me about this? A lot of women will come in and they'll say, I need a breast lift. And I'll say, well, maybe you do, and maybe you don't. And I'll try to flesh things out, ask what it is that bothers them. And usually what bothers them is they've lost volume. They think that means drooping or sagging. No, drooping or sagging for a plastic surgeon is something completely different. For us, if you take a pencil or a ruler or anything, a straight edge, and I would tell them, if you stand up straight in front of a mirror, and you take a straight edge and put it right in that crease, under the breast, and then you look in the mirror. Where is your nipple? Is it above the crease, at the crease, or below the crease? If you're not below the crease, if you're above or at the crease, you may not need to have the lift part at all. It may be just putting an implant in will solve the problem, give you more fullness. It actually rotates the breast a little bit up, so you see more breast underneath the nipple than you did before. And putting an implant in alone without the lift, first of all, it's a much shorter procedure, and at least the way I do this, there are no scars at all. I do all my breast augmentations through a little incision up in the armpit. That scar essentially goes away since I put it in a little skin crease. So months after surgery, I can't even find the scar from a breast augmentation. So, and a lot of women find that a nice surprise, that they thought they needed a big lift, and they really don't. So, you know, that's something that you can check on yourself at home, or if you want to come in during the consult, I'll be happy to take a look at you and let you know which operation I would recommend. Now, in questionable situations, you can go one of either way. I always tell them, look, why don't we just put the implant in now, and if you need to have a lift years from now, you haven't burned any bridges, you can always go back and do the lift, but I prefer not to put the scars on you right away if I can avoid that. So that's my strategy in deciding whether we're just doing an augmentation alone or adding the lift. So there you go. That's kind of the situation with breast lifts, breast augmentations. If you're at all interested in learning more about it, you can always come and for a free consultation with me. I'm happy to show you multiple befores and afters. Give you an idea of what kind of results you can expect. So just give our office a call, 608-271-0500, or go on our website, drbartel.com, and learn more about it. So before I go, though, I'd like to mention one thing. This weekend is Veterans Day. I was never in the military, but I have nothing but utmost respect for those who are and were. So if you see a veteran this weekend, actually, if you see a veteran anytime, do what I do. Thank them for their service to our country. I think that's important. I try to do my part a little bit by giving active vets, people who are active military and the wives of active military personnel a little price break here in the office. It's the least I can do to thank them for their service. But I think it's nice that for them to hear it from us, that we appreciate what all they've done for us. I'll be taking a couple weeks off here with the holidays coming up, but we'll get back at this sometime after Thanksgiving. Hope everyone's healthy. Take care.